so you're done with that. We have, I think, about, I would say 10 to 12 of those a year. So the full-time staff is all about the logistics of that, getting employers in here. We've got one coming up in April, so we've got about 120 employers at, we call that one the just-in-time job fair. Because in April, people are like, ah, what am I gonna do? And the counselors see people here for short 20-minute sessions, like to review a resume or something, or 45-minute sessions to really kind of help you figure out what you're gonna do next, whatever that is, if it's career, if it's grad school, if it's going and traveling. You know, we're here to kind of help you with the whole plan. So, just to get a sense, how many of you here have applied to Cal? I know some. Okay, great. And the rest of you are kind of checking it out. And how many here have a sense, general sense, of what they want to do once they've graduated? Okay, good. A handful. And how many here are just sort of still thinking about that? Yeah, I guess if you don't have a general sense, you're still thinking about it. Well, what we do here is we work with you wherever you are. So if you have an idea of where you want to go next, we sit with you and help you kind of flesh that out. You know, what's that really going to look like, and develop a plan for how to get there. If you don't know what you want to do, if you don't want a job or go to grad school or what, then we back up and work with you there to help you kind of clarify that. We like to put it in terms of kind of three different arenas that people come in to do: explore, engage, and evaluate. And the exploration relates mainly to, first of all, you getting a sense of who you are and what you want, and then linking that to, well, what's out there that's going to fit with that. And if you've worked at the Career Center at College of Marin, you might be familiar with that. It's a pretty common way of doing career counseling. But we always start with you and what you know about what you like, what you're interested in, what you're good at, what's important to you in your life and in your work. And then we go out and say, okay, well, what's out there that's a fit for that? So that's where we start if you really don't have much of an idea of what you want to do. And one of the things that we really look at a lot today is what skills you have that you enjoy using that employers also look for. And a lot of people think that they need to, for example, know how to code in order to get a good job, or they need to be in accounting in order to get a good job, like have these hard skills. But the truth is that, according to a survey by the National Association of College and Employers, the top 10 skills that employers look for these days in new grads are these skills, and they're what we call soft skills. So they're more like the transferable skills that you can develop through your classes, you know, through writing papers, through doing critical thinking of things you're studying, from communicating within teams or collaborative roles. They're not like knowing accounting or being able to, I don't know, split the atom or whatever it is. They're these softer skills. So a lot of folks kind of find that to be good news, because they can sometimes feel like, oh, if I'm not studying one of these technical business type areas, there's nothing for me. That's not true. You want to be focusing on developing these sorts of skills in your classes, as well as whatever content-specific skills like accounting or coding or whatever. But if you're more of an art history person or an English person, focus on these. These are the ones that employers really look for. And you can develop those in classes, in internships, volunteering, student groups. It doesn't have to be just through a job or just through an internship. All right. So I think those are listed on that little green